Good evening, everyone. Thank you for coming tonight. This is concert number 7, right?
Yeah.
7 of 9. Kind of lose track after a while. I'm Dr. Orlando García. I run the composition program at FIU, Florida International University, and I'm the founder of this festival that's been around for 25 years, and with my co-director and good friend, Dr. Jacob Sudol, who runs our music technology program, we want to welcome you to tonight's very special concert. Tonight we have an incredible duo here from Boston. They're incredible performers, as you're going to hear very shortly. There are a couple of pieces that I want to mention specifically that are world premieres, even though the program doesn't say that. But the work by Paula Matthusen, who's here, and Jacob Sudol, who's here, those two pieces are world premieres. So I've asked them to come up and say a few words before you hear the pieces about those works. And then the work after that is my work, which obviously is not a world premiere because it was written about a million years ago. When I was much younger, but I may come up and say a few words about that piece. Just suffice it to say it's very quiet, which sometimes doesn't work that well in Miami Beach, but we'll see how that goes. So again, it's a pleasure to have you here. One last word, the cafe is open, and it'll be open if you want to grab a quick drink or something in the piece. I just ask that you do it in between pieces if you're going to do it. And the restrooms are back there as well, so if you need a restroom, they're back in the cafe as well. So concert number 7, 2 more to go in April. It's all listed in the back. So with any further ado, it's a great pleasure to introduce Transient Canvas. Thank you.
Transient Canvas. Just a quick note about it is that this, the title of this, Start By Bringing Your Most Secret Sound, comes from the beautiful work by Danielle Fogel, a book called Edges and Fray, which is this collection of poetry and writing and images of nests and all these beautiful ways of kind of bringing about space. And in a way, I was thinking a lot about acoustical nests and safe spaces in thinking about this poetry that way. And so the piece is very simple, it's very quiet. It asks the performers to start by bringing their most secret sound. What does that mean? And so they tap into this very gentle world so exquisitely, so I'm very grateful to Transient Canvas.
Thank you. Yeah, I just have a, I'm running live stream, so I had to like switch so people could see what this piece is online. So first of all, tremendous thanks to Transient Canvas for playing a terrific job on my piece. Very, very grateful. There's a program note in here, so I'll say some of that, but not that much. I'm going to butcher the name of this piece. I originally wanted to call this piece like Lost Sounds, but it just sounds like garbage in English, so I was like, okay. Maybe French, Son disparu. And then the reason it's called this is because the sounds in this piece are sounds from Cambodia, are based upon transcriptions and of recordings I made in Cambodia with my mentor, Wolfsonian Museum. This is sort of a birthday gift. He's turning 80 years old this year. So I went to Cambodia with him in 2015. He had been dreaming of recording the sounds that I used as the source material for this piece for about 40 years, since like the late 60s. So we recorded this ancient stone bell from the National Museum. It's been there for 120 years. Nobody had ever heard it. Nobody knows what it's for. So being part of the piece, there are these sort of materials that they're playing, which are content of is recordings of those bells. And then the other thing you want to hear are these really rare, these kites that are these reeds that spin, and they create these really weird melodies and timbres. And so we went out to the rice fields outside of Phnom Penh and recorded with a microphone on top of them what they sounded like. So those were used as sort of transcription source materials for more flowing lines which follow afterwards. So, I'm going to butcher even worse the Khmer title, which I asked Chinnery, can you please name this in Khmer? And he said, yes, Samrak Rasat. So that's what the script after disparu means. Thank you very much. Looking forward.
And of course, I just want to say it's such a treat to be able to come here to a new place for us and to premiere music by people affiliated with Miami. I think it's just wonderful. So congrats to both of you. I'm really excited about this relationship we're building.
Okay, let me say a few words about this piece. Like Amy just mentioned, because I'm a clarinetist, I know fingerings of the clarinet, obviously, because that was my first instrument. So when I wrote this piece, I thought it would be interesting to augment the percussion possibilities that are there, already a percussionist, by having the clarinetist, the bass clarinetist, also play some percussion. So he or she could present pitches while using the one hand, the left hand, right, the finger notes, and then the right hand to like play gongs and triangles and whatever. So that's what you're going to see if you watch. That's why she said it's your percussion debut, because, and it's not really a debut because you guys did the piece already. But
well, anyway, in Miami.
In Miami, right, right. So, so it's your percussion debut in Miami. So you'll see they should be playing some additional percussion instruments in this piece. So let me just say real briefly, some of the stuff is in the notes, so I don't want to like just repeat that. But this piece was written in 1996, which isn't that long ago, because actually my professional career started in 85. So that's how old I am. But so in 96, I wrote this piece for an ensemble in Holland called Duo Contemporain. It was an incredible, just like Matt and Amy are, they're just incredible players. The difference is back then there weren't many of these groups with this instrumentation. But these players are really good. They commissioned the piece and they did it all over Europe, and over the next 3, 4, or 5 years, it got some performances because of them until they broke up as a group. They went their own ways. They're still friends, but they went their own ways. So the piece didn't get too many performances until somewhere in 14, 15, somewhere in there, where a really good Mexican clarinetist, bass clarinetist friend of mine started a duo like this with an incredible percussionist. That's the duo Duplum. Fernando Dominguez and Ivan Manzanillo, which are just a wonderful group, just like, again, another group, great group like this. The nice thing is that there are more groups like that. And actually what really interested them, aside from they were my friends and liked my music, is the fact that my mentor, Morten Feldman, has a very famous piece for bass, clarinet, and percussion. And so they would start their concert that they started presenting this piece in with Feldman's piece and then end with my piece, or vice versa, so that you could somehow compare. Since I was one of his last students, you somehow compare with these pieces, which are kind of different, very different in any case. But that's kind of like the backdrop. So then, not too long ago, Amy and Matt picked up this piece and they did it at a major conference virtually, because it's during a pandemic, and it was just gorgeous. It was just so beautiful. It was just unbelievably the performance. So it was like, okay, so we need to get you down to Miami, and so you can play some of these pieces for us. And sure enough, that's why we have them here. The title, Afternoon Tea with Satie. I love Satie. This doesn't sound anything like Satie, I don't think, so you don't, you know. But I was listening to a lot of Satie at the time and thinking a lot about what he meant and what he was into as I was writing this piece. So without any further ado, Afternoon Tea with Satie.
Can't handle pressure. Okay.
in Tennessee, and we were so blown away by the piece that, of course, we played it at the festival, but then we kept playing it. So, someone asked, how do you gain visibility as a composer? Like, when you can, if you have pieces that fit instrumentations for calls for scores of things like SCI, sometimes, like, that's a great way. João never met us, now we're friends, and he's awesome, he's a great composer, so, like, if, you know, submit stuff, you never know what's gonna happen. This piece is apparently based on heavy metal. When we met João at Tennessee, when we premiered it, you know, we were all like really nervous and fidgety and stuff. And he's like, no, just play, just yeah, just
rock out.
And we're like,
oh,
yeah, he's gonna rock out. So that's the aesthetic. We hope you enjoy. Thanks again for coming, and feel free to chat with us afterwards.
Thank you. Thank you.
Just to add to that, I want to thank you for coming as well as the director of the festival, one of the directors of the festival. I also want to invite you to next week. A week from tonight, we have the next concert. And the next concert is music from North and South America performed by the Notice Ensemble, which is our Miami-based new music professional ensemble. We have Daniela D'Anguillo soprano singing. We have Federico Bonacosa, a great classical guitarist, performing. Luis Gomez-Imbert, an incredible contrabass player, playing. Jesse Gilday, wonderful clarinetist playing, Chen Hui Jen, marvelous pianist playing. So we have a big to-do there. So if you're available next Wednesday at 7:30, we'll probably have a brief pre-concert talk at 7, but at 7:30 is the concert. Please come by, free and open to the public. And then the following week, we have one more concert left with Carlos Sanchez Gutierrez, an incredible Mexican composer who's coming down to visit us from Easton, where he's actually a professor. And again, Notice will be performing at that concert as well. So thank you to Amy and the Matt for this incredible concert, this beautiful concert. And thank you all for coming. And as Amy and Matt have said, they're hanging around. So if you guys want to come up and talk, please feel free to do so.